All right, my name is Nicholas Sean Rashard Thompson. I'm a proud and honored member of the Black Lives for Peace. Real quickly, I'm going to talk about the importance of organization and building an anti-imperialist movement and why this is a necessity for any serious project of revolutionary project, especially in the heart of empire. We have a responsibility to stand in solidarity with our international and global community. So first and foremost, when we look at things like the 1033 program that got mentioned and the mass occupation of our communities and the militarized equipment that comes in from the federal government to our local municipalities, there's a connection to that internationally, right? When we look at the mass occupation and the underdevelopment of the international community and then the underdevelopment of our local communities, it's the same tactics, the same project. Anytime they see resistance, they're going to meet it with violence and force. Mumia, as we said earlier, Free Mumia is dealing with COVID and a heart congenital failure. And when we look at that, that's tied same practices that are going in Haiti, right? And I'll give you a concrete example of that, right? When we look at political prisoners, which I find anybody that is in, a victim of mass incarceration is a political prisoner because we recognize these conditions are manufactured. The poverty that's imposed upon us in the cycle, our communities being underdeveloped again, and then we lead us into crimes of survival that feed the prison system, right? The same tactics are happening internationally, right? It's all to protect one thing, the U.S. capitalist, white supremacist, settler, patriarchy project, right? That's what they're doing. That's their interest. And they're organized. They're massively organized. One of my favorite quotes from Malcolm X is that he says, we are not outnumbered, but we're out-organized. And we don't have a serious anti-imperial project here in the West, right? There's not many organizations that take that very seriously. We can't compromise, we can't capitulate, and we cannot sell out the rest of the globe for healthcare. We can't sell out the rest of the globe for incremental slow change that will eventually be eradicated by the fascist state, right? Now, Malcolm X also told us, they'll sell you a wolf, the Republican Party, they terrify you with their actions, so you run to the fox. Either way, they're both gonna eat you. He's been saying this, W. Du Bois told us in 53, right? Why I won't vote. Malcolm told you in the 60s, there's no such thing as harm reduction and lesser evil voting. There's only harm reallocation, and I will sell out other people for my benefit. Because that's what they want, divide and conquer. But at the end of the day, we're all oppressed by the same system. So this is why it's imperative we organize and join organizations, organizational structures, and find a home that takes imperialism seriously, that are principled, that has political clarity. Now I'm Bobby Baez, I'm gonna tell you to join back. Hey. Or our Solidarity Network, yeah. Right? I'm gonna tell you to join back, yeah. They're serious, right? But please, find an organization, join, and put in work. Whatever you can. Kwame Ture told us, right? Some people give a dollar. Some people give their whole home. Some folks get arrested. Some folks go to jail for life for this cause. Whatever you can give, I'm begging you to give. At your capacity. At your level. Whatever you can. Because we're not going to win disorganized. We're not going to win unless we are taking anti-imperialism very, very seriously. The Global South is being ravaged, destroyed. Operation Condor. AFRICOM. Bombing Somalia, expanding drone strikes into Kenya, Yemen, Syria, all of this. And we cannot sell out and compromise on these issues and these principles. And I'll give you a concrete example. We can disrupt their whole political discourse or their electoral project, the electoral process, and we start taking anti-imperialism seriously. You can't prevaricate, you can't circumvent on demands like end AFRICOM, end the use of economic and all forms of sanctions, in military and occupations and in the meddling in places like Venezuela and other democratically elected places. When you make demands like that, there is no performative action like wearing a kufi and kneeling with you. They can't do it. And we won't capitulate. And when we come together and we refuse to retreat and we refuse not to compromise, we build a sustainable project that is very serious, very principled, and that's how we win, right? So I'm gonna end on this. No compromise.
No retreat.
No compromise.
No retreat.
No compromise.
No retreat.
Get out and join the organization. That's how we win. Thank you. Woo!